I don't want to die young. Whenever you are gone, I just wanna be with you. Please don't get. Hello people, welcome back to my channel. Salut les amis, bienvenue et bon retour sur ma chaîne. Hello people, welcome back to my channel. Salut les amis, bienvenue et bon retour sur ma chaîne. Hola, bienvenue dans mon canal. Konnichiwa, watashi no chaneru ni yukusu. I hope you're doing fine. This is another day, another week, and another video of me. We're talking about intentional wardrobe. I'm gonna be able to pronounce it by the end of this video. I'm probably, yeah, it's a challenge that I just do for myself, you know. An intentional wardrobe, what is it and how you can build one? Who am I to talk to you about it? Well, I'm Lady Tomo, I'm a personal style coach and I'm dedicated and passionate about helping creative women entrepreneurs uncover the authentic style so they can show up 10 times confident in their lives and their businesses because, well, you're worth it, you deserve it, and I take it very personally. It's like my mission, you know. I'm so happy. Okay, let's get to it. If you wake up in the morning feeling stressed because you need to pick out clothes and you kind of have an idea onto how difficult it is for you, pick those pieces from your closet, you know there's a problem, you know there's an issue. Sometimes it's all about you, how you feel that day, how you feel about your current mood and how it is and what is it about your closet. Are there pieces that actually go with your lifestyle, your current lifestyle, or just a dream life? It's all about really, really, really getting through it and taking it into consideration. An intentional wardrobe is literally gonna help you to get rid of probably 80-90% of those frustrations in the morning, the anxiety coming from it. We usually wear 20% of our clothes 80% of time. I know, crazy, right? It even gets worse when you feel anxious, when you feel stressed. You wear even less than that. When it comes to having a closet full of pieces that don't go together, that you're not even wearing, that don't fit you anymore, when it comes to the sizes, when it comes to your lifestyle, when it comes to anything changing in your life, you kind of see really quick that most of the things that you have in your wardrobe actually are not a part of you most of the time. An intentional wardrobe is gonna be the key here to be able to have a wardrobe that goes with you and your authentic style. It's not a minimalist wardrobe and it's not necessarily a capsule wardrobe because we tend to hear a lot of those terms that you pick from intentions, based on a plan, based on a strategy. And sometimes it could be a lot of pieces, but the thing here and the point here is that they are all pieces that actually go together, that actually represent your authentic current lifestyle. The minimalist wardrobe is going to be a choice that you make when it comes to you and how you see your intentional wardrobe to be. It's the same thing when it comes to capsule wardrobe. When you build one, you need to start with the why. You probably heard a lot about starting with whys when it comes to starting a business, when it comes to starting anything in your life. It all starts with your why. I have a book here all about defining your whys and what it is exactly. The same thing applies to wardrobe. When you build a wardrobe, you need to have a strategy. You need the plan that's gonna make your life easier, better, where you're gonna feel the most confident in, and you're gonna be able to save a ton of money and a ton of time. What is the lifestyle you have right now and where do you wanna go? Usually we're gonna think about whatever we feel like at the moment, based on our choices from impulsion, which is probably the worst thing you can ever do. Whatever you add up has to be used minimum 3 ways. Whether it's a skirt, whether it's a top, whether it's a blazer, if you can find minimum 3 ways of wearing whatever you want to buy, adios. Just, it's not the time yet. You guys are not meant to be with each other yet at that moment. You need to think about why are you building one. You need to think about the goal you have. Because usually when you want to add up anything to your closet, it could be the result of something changing in your life. So let's say you're working full-time and you now kind of transitioning from being an entrepreneur full-time. And depending what you're gonna do for your business, depending if you need to go out more, depending if you need to work from home more, you need to think about all those details. If you think about building an agency, for example, you know you're gonna have to go to more networking events to connect with more people. So all of those things need to be thought through before adding anything into your closet. I'm gonna go beyond that. How do you want your wardrobe to make you feel? You need to start with that question every single morning. When you can't seem to find, or you can't seem to have that feeling when it comes to your closet, whenever you open it, this is where the issue starts. Where does that come from? Is it because of me? Is it because of the pieces? Is it because of the day? Is it because of something else? And usually it's always related to something else. This is why I'm always saying it's not about the clothes. Passionate about clothes because it's gonna have a magic effect in all areas of your life. Start from there, you kind of pinpoint the origin and the source of it. You can make the change based on how you dress up. It takes work, it takes practice, it takes a lot of repetition. It makes you feel a lot better in a lot of, if not all, areas of your life. The confidence, you networking, you attracting the right people for you, attracting the right guy for you. All of those things needs to start with a why. It's the versatility. I talked about the minimum 3 ways of wearing stuff. It's related to the versatility of your pieces. We're reaching the age where we look for the quality pieces. You're not looking for having way too many pieces that actually are not gonna serve you a lot. Have quality pieces that are able to last you longer and have fewer pieces. Yes, revolve around those pieces, thinking about basics that every woman should have. The issue you have with your closet is that you don't have the basics. Whatever your size is, you need to have those basics. Gonna make a video out of it probably next week, or maybe the next video is gonna be that. Maybe. It's a start. It doesn't have to be just wearing basics, because at some point you're gonna feel like wearing the same things over and over again. It's all about the little tweaks here. But versatility means having the basics first and then be able to add up the statement pieces, the bolder pieces, and pieces that actually speak more of your style. The combination has to be happening here. Your style, your DNA, the personal style DNA that I always talk about, it's all about those pieces that's gonna add the salt and the pepper in the whole thing. When it comes to intentions, you need to think it through. Something else you can do is to think about your signature look. Janelle Monáe, because for me she represents what I call authentic signature look to the best. Those pieces that you naturally are drawn to makes you feel you. I have a friend, she has that thing with sunglasses. It's a part of her style. She has to wear them, loves it, and she makes it a part of her signature style. Change the colors depending the outfit you have with it. So you can make it in a way that is a part of your signature look, because people are gonna remember it's her. I know it's her. Think and picture Anna Wintour, you always picture with the floral big dress, because it's a part of the style. And when you have that kind of uniform, this is a no-brainer thing in the morning when you need to dress up. You're gonna reach to the same pieces, but probably in different versions, different colors, different prints. And then when you combine them with something else, it gives you an overall different vibe. Powerful for you to not waste money and to not waste time in the morning. So think about your lifestyle. What's your lifestyle is like? Are you the one running, having kids, like younger kids, and love heels? But if you don't seem to be able to walk in them all the time, why are you having a closet full of heels? They're gonna answer me and be like, oh, you know, I love them. Okay, why don't you wear them? It hurts. I'm like, why do you have so many of them then? Don't make them the center of your closet if you can't wear them. It could be the kitten heel. Make it in a way that it could work with your lifestyle. Don't make it just a dream, an actual reality life. About your signature look and being a part of your lifestyle as well. But, you know, make your closet be functional and organized, guys. Like, please have a really weird thing about it. Like, when nothing is organized, it just makes me feel some type of way and I want to kill everybody. For the weekend, if I need to start the day, if I need to make any videos like I do now, I need to clean up, I need to organize everything in a way where I'm gonna feel good, at ease to talk to you with the best energy possible. Everything has its place. So do the same thing for your closet. Your closet has to be a sanctuary. That moment, if it's not organized, if everything is all over the place, no wonder you feel really anxious. Look for something into your closet, right? Make it cute. Make it you. But the you organized, or the you that you want to be. You need to open the closet and feel the vibe and be like, yes, I might be tired, I hate my job, I have to go out when it's like minus 40, Montreal, Canada. But make it a way where it's like vibrant and fun for you. Fun! Fun! Make it fun for you. Make it a way where like it's your moment, it's you, it's your self-care moment. Clean up your outfits. Really important, I said it already in a couple of videos before. Even more important, based on your menstrual cycle, I had a video done on that. I'll probably link it somewhere here, full of insightful tips, and I think it's the best way I could make you plan your outfit in a way that it's gonna be creative for you, inspiring for you, and not necessarily when you're tired and you're not feeling like doing anything. It's all about you making a choice to make it really useful for you, to make it really intentional for you, to make your wardrobe be amazing for you and your life. Let me know what are your best tips. Let me know in the comment box down below. I'm probably gonna see you for the next video. Until then, subscribe to this channel, hit on the bell notification button. There are a lot of times when it comes to the psychology behind dressing up. It's, love it a lot. And follow me on Instagram, because there you're gonna have me sharing a lot of confidence tips when it comes to you feeling a lot more confident and make it really amazing when it comes to the clothes you're gonna have on you. And more so, my little life about me speaking French, English, Korean, Chinese and whatnot. So, j'espère que vous avez aimé la vidéo. Comment est-ce que vous vous organisez? Parce que on a tous nos pratiques et tout when it comes to it. English, French, writer. Vous organisez, comment est-ce que vous organisez vos vêtements de manière à ce que ça ait du sens pour vous et surtout vous. And until then, you probably have guessed it already. Smile, because it's free and contagious. Bye.